Okay. Good. We're all good. Good morning, everyone. How are you? To say that we are not ready for this morning is quite an understatement. So I wanted you to know that we haven't forgotten we're supposed to be here, but just give me 2 seconds. I've just got to set up another light because, as you can see, I'm in the dark. Story of my life. So I will be 2 seconds. I'm just going to set up one more light. We had to move everything around yesterday. And mainly for our health and safety, because I was running around all over the place and I was going to trip on something. Let's see if this plug works. When in doubt, just plug. Ah, there we go. Just plug any light in and see if that works. Is that a little bit better? That's better. How are you all this morning? You would think, wouldn't you, that if I asked, if I said, Gus, can't do another, have to be another day, you think I'd be ready if I had a whole extra day. Good morning, Louise and Anne and Annette and Diana. Hello in Costa Rica. Donna, I might have told you an email. I vowed I'm going to be at Sitges next year. It's on. I'll be there in spirit with my fabric this year, but I'll be coming your way. Hello, Donna. Oh, I've skipped. Hang on. In order. Carol, good morning, Lynn. Yvonne says, hi, everybody. Barb Lawrence is in the building, so is Helen. Donna is here, having a lovely evening in the UK. Donna, what is happening in the UK? I don't know, but I know I have a meeting with Natasha next week. We're finally going to get our act together. Good morning, Helen Cassidy. Barb, yes, Emma would be here usually, but because we moved days, she's actually not. She has a real job at another location. So I can't have her every day, and I would. Elsa, hello! Lovely to see you too. Christine, Davey. Colours behind me. Oh, there's a story, Christine. There is a story, and it saved us, our tush. Michelle Fisher, you have been mentioned in vain on a post for A Quilter's Life this morning, which was going to go live this morning, but I forgot Cass couldn't do this morning, and Facebook have changed their whole admin setup again. So Cass is going to deal with that and pop it up this afternoon. There are 3 things going up for Quilter's Life today. Good morning, Sharon. All right, you can watch till 11 a.m. and that's about exactly when we are going to finish up. So that's all fine. Christine is here from Berrigan in New South Wales, which is lovely. Sally, the dentist. I'm got my tongue up on my teeth because of the dentist. There was a severe toothache, and with a show this weekend, I thought, no, it'll be fine. And then I went, can you imagine doing 3 days of a show with a toothache? So I got to the dentist and was there forever, and there's nothing. It's just, it was a sore gum. I still have some reminiscent little faux pas every now and then to do with the surgery I had on my mouth last year. So it's all fixed, but thank you very much. And yeah, lost half a day. Good morning, Deb, Marie, Margaret. I could put my glasses on. Joan, hello. Bronwyn's here as well. You're all in. I know some couldn't make it this morning, so if you're watching it after the show, I'm really, really sorry we changed the day. But do you know, Patricia Branford. Patricia Branford, your order is here. We are waiting for a courier to bring a delivery today with pale denim. That is why your order has not left the building. I should have probably given you a run and talked for half an hour, but I didn't. But it's due today, so your order's going out as soon as that arrives. Ruth, Roslyn. Yes, Diana. Yeah, we get Costa Rica. Everyone, is everyone coming to Spain next year for the show? It's in Sitges. It's down on the beach, 20 minutes outside Barcelona. All those that wish to come to Barcelona, hands up, and I will organise the tour. Might get a couple of my friends that know more about tours to organise that. Can you imagine if you all said yes? It'd be a bit scary, wouldn't it? Felicity would come. Thanks, Flick. Glad you think I'm looking good. You know I love my Selvos, and I do not. I can't wait. I'm crooked. I cannot justify a budget for a new top for all of you every show. This one does not match the set. really, except for the cushion. This one was $7 at my local Salvation Army. I dropped off 3 tops and picked up 1. That is the rule. You do not, it's not like when I used to go to the tip with Dad to take a trailer load and come home with a new trailer load and Mum would spit it. Great, Ilse, you're coming this weekend to Morwell. Excellent, good morning, Rhonda. Donna, you live in England. We would expect you to say the weather isn't great here in the UK. It's wet and windy. But do you know, I was there in Feb 2019 with Phil, and I warned him about winter, and it was freezing cold the morning. I got him off the plane, got a full English breakfast with black pudding into him on the way, and I had him at Stonehenge straight from Heathrow at 9 a.m. in the morning, and it was blistering, and it was freezing cold, and it was raining, and he accepted that because I'd warned him. The rest of the 3 weeks were sunny and 15 degrees. We were in t-shirts up in my mum's village in Dedham, walking along the river. Amazing. So, but I would expect to be wet and windy. My family have finally reopened their fish and chip shop. Chilver's Fish and Chip Shop in Manningtree, a year after there was a big fire in the flat above, and they lost the lot a year because of COVID and building and everything. So I'm very excited. I'm trying to get the time difference right so I can ring and try and place an order for delivery. We have background music from the shop phone. I'll get to that later and see who was trying to ring us. Kathy, Bernadette, we've done or been there. Good morning, Karen. Good morning, Denise. Yes, garden. I've got the sprinkler on, the drip feed on out the back. Good morning, Jeanette, Linda, Carol, Cheryl. Are we all in? Melissa's coming to Craft Alive on Sunday. Louise, you said you're coming as well, aren't you? Do I need to remind you you don't live around the corner from Morwell, Louise? Yvonne's coming as well. Oh my goodness, it's a party house, girls. Hello, Fiona. Lovely for you to join us. Hola, yeah, Felicity, we have to learn Spanish and no tapas and hola are not enough. So in vowing that I will be next year, I've got a year to get my Spanish up to the same as my friend Maria, who owns Field of Fada in Spain, in Valencia. Pecan, to be correct. But yes, I used to go off crook at people. Well, not go off crook, but I used to look at people a little disdained when they go, oh, and I've been to Cordoba, and we went down to Seville and Valencia and everything, and it's now I do it, but not kind of like a brag. That just happens to be, you know, my friend Diana in Costa Rica and my mate Maria in Picanha, just outside Valencia. See, it just rolls off the tongue. Yes, Donna, I have a feeling you are multilingual. Oh, I see. You've got your sister down there. Awesome. 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 Yeah, Jill, I don't, you know, I may wear this top once or twice, but for $7, even though I can't keep it on straight, even for $7, you just got to pull the front lace out and there's no chain up here. For $7, to me, that is the same as a coffee and a bickie at a cafe with a friend. And it's a whole top. And you wear it twice. And then you donate it back for someone else, and it just keeps going. Then everyone keeps buying the same top if you look after it, and it's just more and more money for charity. Whichever op shop I go to, my favorite is Parkdale, but wherever I am, I try and do that. Jill. Oh, good morning, Gwen. Jill, you need to leave the country. Get a passport. It's got to happen. Got to go. But we're all going to get there. Now, the reason for the colour of the stand. I was going to make this a quick show and I've been babbling on, so we've better speed it up. The colour of the stand all came about this morning because we have not attended a multi-vendor, let's use the technical term, a multi-vendor quilt show, like Australasian Quilt Convention, Craft Alive, Craft and Quilt Shows for, drum roll please, 3 years. And the last one was not even here. I did Houston and Birmingham in the 1 year after we did the Australian Textile Exhibition. And by that stage, I wasn't doing AQC or the others at that stage anymore. because we were in full textile pantry wholesale mode, which we're about to do again, but with Chandler's Cottage as well, home base. So it's, you know, it all goes around in cycles. And of course it's a big year because it's our 20th birthday this year. So it is really the time to reflect and work out what's where, when. It is at least 3-4 years. It was up for debate yesterday, which means we are completely out of practice. And, you know, Margaret and Karen said, oh, just put in the car, just fill the car with whatever's there. It doesn't work like that now because we have stock, we have all our things for you on our website, but if I take them away from here, if someone orders something on the weekend, it's with me and I may have sold it at the same time to someone else. So we don't have separate show stock anymore, haven't done for a very long time. So it has been a massive learning curve on how to manage it. So some things you may go looking for on the website this weekend and you'll go, how can that possibly be out of stock? It doesn't mean it's out of stock. It means it's not just treated as not available. It's either on order coming in with a lot of our hubby at the moment, or we have taken it with us to Morwell, so it will chop and change around. Similarly, if you're coming to Morwell, please don't expect us to have absolutely everything that's on our website with us. I have a small stand, as everyone does at Craft Alive. I'm taking stuff, and I'm taking pretty much all my fabric ranges that are mine, and kits and little bits and pieces. We can't take everything. So if you get there and you're a bit disappointed, I haven't got exactly what you were after, don't worry, we will talk about it when you're there and we'll work something out for you, but can't fit everything. Anyway, in the rush and everything to get stuff ready, and honestly, we're still not ready. We've been flat out for about 4 or 5 days going, can we take that? Ooh, applique essential packs, we've only got 3, we'd better make another 10 to put in the cart. All that stuff's going on. We've got to finish a lot of stuff today. There was a death in the studio. No, it wasn't a mouse from Ginny or anything like that. It was the printer. Now, when printers die that you have had for a very, very long time, that have been through exhibitions with you, publishing, you know, probably printed the first, I don't know, Melba pattern on it. I know it's just a thing, but it's like when the sewing machine dies or the car dies or something, you get a bit upset because, you know, there are memories attached. It died 6:30. No, it actually died yesterday, but Rob declared it time of death this morning. And he went, oh, new printer. We have put it off. Oh, thanks, Steve. We have put it off. Thanks, Steve. Okay, I got it. Yes, the printer died. And he sort of went, new printer. For us, the new printer is a big thing that does A3 scanning and printing and everything, so it's not a small purchase. And I was thinking, how do I explain to the girls without swearing how annoyed I am? Well, you can think of all the words. And I was going through miffed, whatever, jaded. Ooh, I like the word jaded. I went, let's do a jade day. So I put everything out jade. I'm going to use a little bit for demoing. Plus I've got the new ginger jar. You said a ginger jar, Steve? Yes, ginger jar. Ginger jar. Kept calling it a pot. Ginger jar cushion as well as a kit and a pattern going up later today. So I thought this will work. So on your tag on the top of the page on our website, you will find everything is tagged for today, and all of these jade coloured fabrics, I know we're going to have that whole jade green teal conversation at some stage, these have all just been, you know, maybe just dropped a little bit for the day, because it is buy a new printer day. I am not going to lie to you, today is all about just, you know, helping generate the funds. It's the GoFundMe account for the printer. Because it was, you know, when the washing machine dies and you go, oh, I know people that have a washing machine, a white goods stash, they do. So these are all down a little bit, and that just gave me a good excuse too to set up the stand. including the boys. I got the dragons up, one of Steve's favourite fabrics, which you've stashed a bolt, haven't you? Stevie? He's out of earshot now. He has stashed a bolt of the jade dragons for me to make him just a whole cloth doona cover, evidently. Now, I also had these on special over the weekend. I was really sneaky. I did little Instagram, Facebook limited time specials because I could. And I've still got some of these left. So these are also tagged for today, and I've just pushed the wrong button. But do you know, that button might actually work better. Let's go to this one. Because I zoomed in the camera, let me just move these just a little bit over to the side. So these are all, I'm pretty sure Steve just went half price. So I'm not sure, this one, I think I mentioned to you, this one is still here because it never ended up at the website. So you can see we've eaten into a fair bit of it, but it is still here and it is gorgeous, fussy cutting down bags, the whole lot. So this one is up, it's a beautiful seven berry. That one's there. A lot of this one went, but I've still got a couple of meters of it. That lovely little canvas studio. This will go with Melba in the orange and black really, really well. So that one is on half price. Oh, we've only got half a meter of the cranes left. That was the seven berry. They're not really in any order, are they? Now, this lovely thing, I ended up with two bolts off by mistake. I don't know what happened. That is a Michael Miller. It is a lovely coral pink with a splash of yellow. I just look at things like this, and even though I don't have lots of little girls around. Good morning, Debbie. I think that's a little girl's dress all day long. That's just lovely. These, if you're wondering about the scale, they are probably about an inch and a half, those big ones there. So it's not a huge pattern, but I think that that would be super gorgeous. This one we had up last week with our doves. So if you did order those fabrics or anything else last week, you've got your little free dove pattern and a little fat eighth of to play with. Oh, thanks, Gwen. Yeah, I'm trying to look at it positively. 20 years, I don't feel too old. I just look at Steve because he's 20 and I feel old. All right, so there's this one that was the Niwa range, and this went really well. I put this on special last week when we launched all the blue fabrics from Timeless Treasures, because if you were making cushions or a quilt or something, this would be, at this price, an exceptionally great fabric to complement and have on the back of your quilts. There's still a little bit of our medallion left. And again, with this one, this would be fantastic to buy a meter of as the backing if you have ordered, if you got your Rachel Daisy cushion pack last week to make her big folded cushion, which is, it's here. Hang on, I'll go and get it. We have sold out of the kits of the fabrics of this roll. This is gone. And you're saying, Lisa, there's one right in front of you. Yeah, I know, but yeah, but oh, yes, however, oh, thank God. Hopefully Mum doesn't hear that. This one is a prize. So hang tight, I'll explain if you don't know about that. But with this cushion, that's what I used on the back. You do need more than half a meter. But if you grab a meter at half price, you can do a nice folded over back, as Rachel suggests on the actual pattern, or make a smaller cushion. The other thing that would look really funky on the back, it's the medallion, is the turtles. So the turtles are done. We also have this gorgeous little print here, which is a little sort of Nouveau Reflections print. That's really nice. And again, for me, little bit of dark rusty chocolate brown, beautiful bag, just beautiful. Hi, finally here, enjoy my world. Thanks, Jackie. We will. I say me as in myself and Karen and Margaret are all together in a row. Huey, Dewey, Louie. Timeless Treasures. No, that's not true. I take that back. In the beginning, Unusual Garden by Jason. So we had this in the teal. We've still got some of the lovely orange left. Beautiful splash of colour. It is really a summer this year now, isn't it? Heaven forbid I've popped the William Morris on. I think it's more to do with the fact that this poor little baby does not have a real home at Chandler's Cottage on our shelves. He gets put in with the Orientals, but he really wants to hang out with all of the Liberties, and he just doesn't know where to go. But he's here, and we've sold, this is our second bolt, and there's probably, I don't know, there's probably about 4 meters left on there. Just lovely. If you, again, if you need a backing for Melbourne Nouveau, this would be beautiful. And if you've got your little stash of our lovely cottagey Liberty cottons, it will go with those really well. And then the last one is that thing I can't say that I put up last week with that gorgeous new fairy frost called Girl, Saguaro. That's as close as I'm going to get. I am not going to try any harder. You are doing me such a favour to take it so I don't have to pronounce it anymore. That's what... Who said that? Kate says, great to start my birthday with Natasha and end with you. Oh, happy birthday, Kate. Yes, you do have a quilt show in Harrogate this weekend, and it used to... It was funny because when Phil and I were in the UK 3 years ago, we went to Sitges, which is the trade show at NEC. We were there for the trade show launching into the UK, which just went all by the wayside, of course, with COVID, and which was a shame. But everyone's going, oh, you're staying in Harrogate. And I'm going, no, I have to go and see family in York, and I have to go to Essex to family, and I have to... Actually, it's funny I say family in York because they aren't my family, but I felt like they were family once I'd been to visit friends of friends. So, no, I had things to do, and I didn't have a show stand with me. So I hope Harrogate goes really well, actually, Kate. Everything, you know, everything leads to Birmingham, doesn't it? Now, this roll, so there are your half-price ones if you want to run off and grab those, but this roll is sitting here because... If you missed last week's show, please don't forget, and a lot have already bought, this gorgeous thing here, which Steve's tagged again today, by Elizabeth Studios, is Tucson. And this is really, really cool. It looks like it has been stitched or beaded, and it is a 60-centimeter panel. And... What we decided to do on the day, was actually set it up that if you buy any of this, if you send us a photo, I'm laughing because of what Michelle Fisher sent me, if you send us a photo of what you've made with it by the 1st of May, we will take your photos and we are going to send them to Rachel Daisy. And ask her, I've left her a message, I'll get back to her, ask her to judge a winner. And in return for the winner, you win the roll of all of these beautiful Figos and a copy of Rachel's pattern so you too can make the cushion. That's the prize. So you get to buy the fabric and then you get to go in the drawer. You don't have to send us the actual bag or whatever you're making, we just need a photo. That's all we need. Michelle Fisher sent me a photo and her gorgeous granddaughter had taken all of the panels that Michelle had obviously cut out and she had turned them all into little mini blankets for all of her dolls on the floor. And it is a precious, precious photo. So Michelle's just gone, well, someone's found a use for all of the panels. We should just send that to Rachel. You know, Michelle is a wild card, that photo. It was really, really good. Okay, I'll pop that safely over there. Now, one more thing in terms of business as well. We have got Stevie. Yeah. Can you do that random number generator thing for me? From last Tuesday, 2 p.m. through to midnight Sunday. Tough. Steve's going to organise the numbers for me so we can do the random generator thing on his phone to find out the winner of last week's birthday celebration pack, which is this one that's got half a metre of fairy frost, half a metre of Northcote shimmer, and a one-off only piece of Melba that is straight from the factory that has rose metallic gold on it that we are not going ahead with, so it's the only piece of fabric in the world that will ever have that rose metallic gold on it. So that winner will be announced as soon as Steve's done that for me. And then this is next week's pack. So I've got one more Liberty pack that I would like to offer out. I'm just trying to find where you've all gone because I've lost your messages. There we go. This is next week's prize. After that, you'll be getting lots and lots of my stuff. There you go. So next week's prize is this pack, or this week's prize. So what it is, you've got five fat quarters of Liberty, but the way this works, if you haven't heard before, if you order from 2 p.m. today, so we've just started the show, through till midnight Sunday. Yeah, it's one day less, but that's fine. Till midnight Sunday, we then take all of your order numbers and put them into a little random number generator, and it spits out a number, which we'll do live today on the show, and that person wins. So that's next week's prize. Steve's going to do that for me in a minute, so I'll pop those away. Now, with our little short sweet show today, with all of these jades, you will find them all on special. I took the liberty of cutting, there wasn't any Liberty jade. I took the liberty of cutting the six that I chose. Why is there seven there? Oh, hang on. Yeah, there's one. There's one that's not cut. That's all right. I took the liberty of cutting them down so I could show them to you instead of having to pull all the bolts off. I've learnt this finally, haven't I? So in our little collection that are marked down a bit, beautiful dark jade shadow plate. This goes really, really well with Melba Nouveau. It is a really nice contrast, particularly with the grey and pink. That works very, very well. We used it, you know, we used it a lot when we first launched Melba, but, you know, along the way you forget these things. So, yes. Thank you, Debbie. Melba is, you know, Melba was supposed to be a one-off 5 years later. I'm still reprinting and doing new colours. So Melba and Under the Australian Sun are definitely babies born at Chandler's Cottage that we now kind of, you know, foster out and share with shops everywhere, which is really nice. Right, this is, I'm feeling bad about this because I'm sure someone ordered this and I filled an order on the weekend, but I think they only ordered half a metre. So this is that gorgeous cattle leather hide imitation, and that is just lovely emeraldy, greeny, jadey goodness, and it looks like it's punched leather, but it's not. Digitally printed, very clever, with a grey black on it. Then this is uncorked in green. So uncorked means it looks like it's cork fabric, but it's actually not. It's just a lovely cotton that's been printed, and it's even got that little splash of gold through it that we have on our cork fabrics. So if you don't want to work with cork, you might like to have a go with that. I can't help but love that with purple. I don't know that I'd actually even make anything in terms of a bag in that colour and purple, but I like looking at them together on the shelf. That's one thing. Oh, no, and there's another one here that actually has purple in it. This one is our... Do you want to do this now?
Can do.
Can do? Shall we just... We'll interrupt. So this is... What do?
Just hold it up to the camera and press the blue button.
Like that? And push the blue button? With the... Oh, yeah, sorry, it's not. I still think about that. No, I've done it wrong. I moved the mouse, Steve. So I do that. You push it. I'm not pushing the right spot.
Don't That's
that it?
3358.
3358? Wait, I did push it.
No, that's not fair. I gotta
do it properly. That's just...
That was right.
Are you saying I need to have a price for 3358 and 4?
No, just push it once. Just push the blue button once.
This button on here, yes. Or here? On the screen?
No, on the touchpad.
Yep. It says number 7.
You've got to move the mouse onto the button, Mum.
Got it.
There you go. 3362.
3, you hold it up like that. 3362. 3362. Find out who 3358 is too. And okay. I will do something. 3362. So if that's your order number, Steve's going to go look those two up. 3362, we'll get that. I actually have something else super, super, super cool. We did 2 rose pinks. And again, we're not going ahead with this one, but I'm going to pack this piece off with the same fabrics because when you push the generator, and I didn't know, so I ended up with 2 people. But have a look at this bit. This was a small floral done with the rose pink on it as well, but we're not going ahead with that. I've got 2 bits of this. I'm sending one off to Carmen.
3362 was a club, and 2 was 3358.
Do it again. We're not doing club ones. No, no, and no. They have to be... Oh, because it's subscription week for Be Mindful and everything. All of our girls going through. All right, give me another one.
3348. Barbara Clifford.
Barbara Clifford.
There we go.
We're sending Barb something today.
Yeah.
Okay, Barb Clifford, that's yours. And then 3358 doesn't matter anyway. I'll put that aside and put something together. That was the most... We will never get a job with tats, Steve. Or Powerball. Sharon Key says it's not her. She'll have to try again. You sound like me with Powerball. I don't do it anymore. It's just, I used to do it when there were jackpots. And then I walk in, I go, I can spend that money. So I don't do it. Okay, this one. Do you remember all of those lovely, lovely tealy blues we had with the panels, with the kits and everything? This came through in that collection and I haven't displayed it at all. So this is another one that's beautiful jade and it does have that splash of purple through it. So that one's gorgeous. Drop dead beautiful Hoffman Batik. It's not showing up on the camera as dark as it actually is. Let me try it on the overhead. Just yummy, yummy. And then the boys are in. The dragons are in. So all of those are tagged and marked down today under $220 a meter for you. So that's under $10 if you buy it by the half meter. So I'll pop these back up here. And then, of course, maybe I'll leave them down. I had to go play with threads. It was really lovely that I've seen that some of you have taken me up on what I suggested in terms of threads, and that's really nice because I also appreciate that a lot of you are not able to get to patch workshops on a regular basis, and that's why I like to be able to show you what threads go together well. Hello Mel, who go together really well for you. So I put together this little jar, little dish of everything that went with these fabrics this morning. One thing that I thought would be nice to point out is that we do have this gorgeous, wonderful pearl thread. It's 8 weight. Look at the colour of that. That's just yummy. And if I hold it, I just love the idea of using something, maybe even like one of these two, and popping some stitching onto black linen or just onto black with that. Would really, really pop, and that would be nice. So I did that one. We've uploaded this morning these variegated metlers, which are a poly sheen. So this is machine embroidery thread. You could put any color green in the bobbin with that, but I might have to take just the wrapper off so that you can see that a bit better. Look at the color of that. So they're up now. So this is variegated. Pop it with anything from a cream, a pale green, or a dark green bottom line, or something similar, whatever you put in your bobbin with your machine embroidery threads, but you need it to be a poly. But again, if you look at that, just yum. I actually think this color with gold metallic coming up, you know, that's heading towards Christmas, winter, ivy, all that stuff. And then for hand sewing or just dropping down your tension a little bit on your machine, we've got Fainas in three different colors that sort of all blend. This one is number 18. It is a, oh, good morning, Robin Epcot. This is, heavens. That pilot could just about, you know, reach out and grab something out of my garden. He's so low. That is probably the best match towards these lighter greens here. And that one is number 18. So we've tagged that one. That's a, if, you know, if you were doing applique with that, that's perfect. So, and then I grabbed number 7 and number 9. Now these weight their way towards teal, more teal blue, but that is going to make them perhaps just a little bit more flexible, because you'd be able to run them through right through into teals if you wanted to. What's a good example? Our teal applique essential pack. So they would run through into that, but they will also work back the other way and work with greens for you. So just so you know that they're there. Just, and I got to play with colour, which was really nice. All right. So as I mentioned, Morwell this weekend, there's a few things missing or low on the website, and then when we come back next week, they'll be back up, but also there'll be new things, because we've done a few little extra new packs and things, but they're going with us first, because that's just easier, and then we'll bring them back. I forgot the blossom in the jade. That one is also up, a little bit special this morning too. This is featured in our little charm purse kits, but not much else at the moment. And you can see he was designed to go with the dragons. Yeah, it all goes. It all goes. So that one's on special as well. Now with the cushion, which I have a feeling I mentioned to you. Oh, I'm sorry. Michelle, do you understand what Michelle Fish has written? She's not just being silly, she literally lives 5 minutes up the road. So it came over us first and then over her. I tell you what, Michelle, we better remember not to do a show when the air show's on, because the boys fly down from the Air Force Air Base, somewhere up near Canberra. They come down in the jets and they fly right through here along the bay and out to Laverton Airport, where they have the air show, and it's exciting, but it wouldn't be a day that we would want to do a show, that's for sure. So we talked about this, my goodness, so long ago, and I don't think I'm getting anywhere, and I'm treading water some days, and every now and then we have a bit of a win and we finish something off. So we finished off the ginger jar, and I still think it might be called a ginger pot on the pattern, Steve. Jury's out. We will come back. It's a ginger something, and it's a cushion kit. So this one is done. For those that are in the applique sampler club, you're all over this, because you've got your biscuit barrel, and it is the same technique as what we did for that. So there are two main parts to it in terms of techniques. You're going pre-shaping by sewing and bagging out your lid and the actual jar, and it's a really, really nice, quick, easy technique. It's what we'll be using in the Never Never Geisha in the Moonlight quilt, which I worked on again. You know, I kind of run away now and sit in a corner and work on it like a naughty girl, it's just because I want to do it. And also, in that quilt coming up, we've got octagon paper piecing, so that's all in this kit, and I'll show you what's in it and the basics of how it all works for this morning. Steve, yeah. One more request. Yeah. Could you please put Pelon 630 on target for me? Yeah. Thanks. thank you. And then bring me a roll or a bit. So this is actually padded out with pelon underneath here. I just forgot to get a bit and tag it. Pre-shaping bag out, little pre-shaped, little knob on the top. The pattern's not up yet as a digital download, and it will be later today because we had it all ready to go, and I just walked past it this morning and went, we forgot the knob. We forgot to put the instructions for the knob in, which are just the classic way that I start pre-shaping a Suffolk puff. That's all it is, but it needs to go in the pattern. But you've got all the instructions in the pattern for all of this, and the paper piecing, and a little diagram of the octagons. But if you do grab the kit, I've actually put in the templates for one corner for you. So the kits will have, this is called doing things on the fly, because literally these are all just, you know, gone together, and we've just got to put the pattern in. So this little strip here is for your octagons, and can you see them? I've put in enough to do one corner, because you make one corner at a time. So there are all your little epiplex templates for your, can you see that? I think you do. We always have this problem, don't we? I'll sit it on the red. No, that's because they're clear. There you go. So in there, and you've got enough to do one corner at a time. So that's there. I'll show you that more in a minute. Then you've got your red Melba fans. This is the fun thing that's come from Melba. We were just talking about it, that the original range didn't have this in, and then I realized we had this need for a tonal print that was more sort of geometric and directional. So I took the fan base off the fans on the big project panel and made this. But 9 times out of 10 now, because of the way that this has come out, it actually gets used with oriental fabrics. So then the story just continued. So we now have several, there we go, now we have several colors in it, and I've just signed off to go to Strike Off in Japan, a new colour which, for want of a better word, is periwinkle. And periwinkle, so that lovely blue-purple colour. And then that will sit tight until Imperial Garden is finished, and we will colour match that with Imperial Garden. So I'm just bringing out two prints, a panel and a print at the moment this year. And so periwinkle going to that. So we just slowly build up a little repertoire of colours, and then it just becomes a coordinate range on its own, separate to Melba. So that's, you know, another part of the boring story of Chandler's Cottage. All right, so this, that's for your corners. This is your square for your ginger pot jar. And then you've got a half a metre at least. You've got half a metre of the lattice, which is your background for the front and the back. Now, we have a second colourway coming out, but I'm not going to pop the kit out and release it until I've actually made the sample. So if you're not a red girl, sit tight. This will be the other one. So the blue one actually has Melba fans in the grey silver with that floral from Summer Palace, and Shadow Play for the top with this. And again, you can see it's got its pieces in. So I've started work on the blue one and finished the red one, but I need to get them both done, of course. Then you've also got non-woven, non-adhesive. Oh, Stevie, I did the wrong one. Non-adhesive interfacing in your kit. You've got enough for your lid on your cushion, and you've also got enough for the pot. So they're both in there. And you also get in the kit a piece of 630, the thinner pelon adhesive, because you're going to pad out your pot. So it's got a really 3D look about it. Now, so I got Steve to tag. I think I got Steve to tag the wrong one. You want non-woven, non-adhesive interfacing. And I actually think I got it wrong this morning when we tagged it. So when he's back, I will fix that up for you. And look at you. I love the red, I love the blue, and Debbie likes both. That's funny. So just, I'll show you where what I've done. I'm making both as well. It's sort of a bit like share the love. There's a little bit of a time plan in progress. So the way it works is make the red one, show it to you, show it to you, and then take it with me to Morwell, and then bring it back and send it to Spain for Maria for the Sitcher show in Barcelona with the fabrics that all go with it. And then come home, finish the blue one, show it to you, and then pack it off with all of the kits and send it to Natasha in the UK. So I sort of do them and then I split the love.
This one?
I'm so sorry. Yeah, give me a feel for that one. Non-woven, non-adhesive. I think you feel this. It's a soft, it's the birch, it's a softer one. But it's still non-adhesive. Can't listen to him. All right. So this is where I'm at with this one. I haven't done the jar yet. Oh. A couple of my guys have got a little bit. That looks better. That's better. Is that non-adhesive? It's not shiny. What's it say?
Yeah, that one's shiny, but this one isn't, but it feels the same.
Yeah, no, I've got a non-adhesive one somewhere as well. But anyway, tag this one, Steve. This one will be all right. We have so many. So these are my little corners. Now, admittedly, yes, I have done them all at once to show you, and I do have a stash of the octagons because they're all sitting here. Yes.
This isn't on the website, though. This is a...
Well, then, if the girls order this, we'll send them that. Because they're both the same thing, just one's a bit stiffer.
How much do you reckon's on there?
Or 10. It'd be 10 metres because it's nice and thin. Alrighty. So you can see I've got my four corners ready to go. I was going to buy tablecloths today for more wool and I just went... You know, I really don't know what colour I'm going to want next time. And I found a roll of really, really nice white, 100% cotton. I'm just ironing this over because my corners have kicked up while I've had it stored in a box. Extra wide, 100% white cotton fabric. I have no idea, everyone, what I bought it for, why it's here. So I'm going to take it with me and use it for my tablecloths, and then I will bring them home and hem them so they're permanent tablecloths, and hopefully by that stage I'll remember what it was for. Don't you love these templates? Because you can hit them with an iron. And then I'll use the rest of the bolt for whatever I had intended it for. There we go. So that will be my four corners. Actually, I'm going to take this with me to Morwell because there is nothing more frustrating than doing a show for the day or teaching a workshop, I'll be honest, and not getting to sew. I always spend money. The shops that are going to be there are going to love me because I haven't had quilt show, either of you probably, quilt show retail therapy for a very long time. So it'll be, Margie, can you mind my stand? Karen, can you mind my stand? And run off and buy stuff. But also when you do the show or when you teach a workshop, you just want to sit down and sew afterwards because all day you've been watching other people sew. So I think I'm going to pack this and take it with me with... my stool, which is under the table, so I'll push that towards the door, and And a little quiet moment or a little quiet bit in the evening when sitting down with the girls. And yes, I'm going to sew these on. So I will give them a really good starch and take out the templates, little dab of glue, and stick them and stick it down. Then I'll probably just pin, and then I can slip stitch around them. I didn't bother. You can call it lazy, or you can say I was making it up as I went. Absolutely, I got, who got, what, where, when, what did I miss? Who, why has Fiona got stitches? Oh no, oh, your dad's had a melanoma removed, ouch. Yeah, well, Robbie's right there with him. Ouch, ouch, so he's got stitches. We got skin graft. Gwen. Like the blue colourway. It's a bit different, isn't it? My mate Jimmy helped me do that at my fabric agent. I did all of the China blue, and we were actually doing a second colourway along purples, and I wasn't happy with it. He suggested the moss green and the grey, and it just, yeah, kudos to him. It's just, so I don't sort of feel like this was mine. So I think I appreciate it a bit more because this was Jimbo's idea. Clever man. Missing lots. We haven't done anything together for a while, so the band will be back together next week, I think, a week after. All right, so I'm going to dab a glue, get them on, pin them on, slip stitch them on. I didn't slip stitch down that bit. I kind of like the fact it's open. But if you've got little people that are going to stick their fingers in there or stick bits of chewy down there or something, you may like to sew that down. Alright, now I want to show you just quickly, if you haven't worked with octagons before, how this is going to pan out for you and how the jar works. Alright, so I'll move these off here, make sure they go in my bag. So if you're at Morwell, you can say, Lisa, where's your pillow? Where's your cushion? We should be sewing. Alright. Now I'm going to steal, I am going to go and steal a bit of fabric. 1 second, girls. Well, just, I don't want to eat into your kits. Here's a bit. Okay. Right. So I've just grabbed just a little bit we had sitting out there. And the whole idea is with octagons is that you can actually cut squares and then trim them down. So these guys are 1.5 wide, but they are not equilateral. They have 4 long and 4 short sides, which gives you this really unique lattice look, particularly for this and the geisha, you know, on the Never Never. So what I actually do is I pop a little bit of glue down onto this. If I'm not going to actually pre-cut squares, just a dab of glue, and then I can come round and cut it out. Otherwise, the really good way to do it, all my sewing gears are not in this room today, so you'll just have to forgive me. I'm working with big stuff. Is at 1/4 inch, seam allowance, which means you're going to come up to a 2-inch square. 2 inch is going to be scant. You could go to 2.25 if you wanted to, but you're just going to bring that down to that size, like that. Let me just move this out of the way. So you can see I've just got enough to bring these over onto the sides. So what that means is that once that's glued on, or you've got it where you want it to be, you can then come around, if you want to, only if you want to, I mean, you could tack all of that corner down, But then just come round. Just sneak off the corners if you don't want it too bulky. And then that's all it is. So even though it is an octagon shape, you don't necessarily need to sit down and cut all of your fabric out in an octagon and cut it down to squares and then trim off the corners. You know, I'm going to fess up to you. The Never Never Geisha that I started talking about probably about 7-8 months ago, I always wonder why I put things off. And it's not just time, a lot of it are mental blocks. The geisha I started quite a while ago, and started so long ago, it was before I had Epiplex available to me. I was getting the templates made in plastic. So, no, Gwen, I didn't buy it. For the tablecloths. I bought it for something. I think it's to do like a big foundation piece, something. I will remember eventually. Anyway, I was working with paper and I didn't trim off the corners. And now when I go back and look at the all of this lattice that I've done for this inner border for my geisha, I don't like it. I find it's too bulky because I didn't trim. The paper's not giving me as crisp an edge as the Epiplex does that I'm used to. I know that when I take the photo of the finished quilt, that you won't be able to tell from where you are, but I can, and I just find these are so much easier and faster to work with. Only half the border is done, so I'm now in that throes. Do I go back and start again? And that's a time thing, but also because I've got such a limited amount of fabric, I'm probably eating into someone else's, like one less kit that I can offer, or I suck it up and finish it with the paper. I think I just made up my mind we're going Epiplex. There's another thing I can take to Morwell with me to do. I'm ironing these on for you, so you can, you know, for you, just for you, so you can see what it looks like. These little irons are fantastic, but here's a heads up warning, because they're so little, you miss seeing them like a big iron. You've got to be careful. So, Melissa, it's Melissa, isn't it? Melissa, you said, oh, hi, Cindy. Diana. Oh, okay, Diana, I won't start again. Good morning, Kathy. I'll send them to you in Costa Rica and you can do them for me in your shop. Is it Melissa? Someone said, Melissa said, Danny said at Epiplex, I can't remember, that they iron theirs over, which I've just done there. But ironing for me doesn't always work. Hexagons, great. But ironing doesn't always work for me, because they may not get used straight away, and because I do have sides that don't actually get sewn to other sides. So, you know, there's little holes that don't get filled in, so I like to still tack mine. The iron is quite good though. You could iron them all and then tack. I suppose that's two steps, but that whole glue and having to hold down is gone. So if you do have trouble with your hands, and you could do a quick attack, you wouldn't need to do the back stitch on each corner. I'll have a play and let you know. But yeah, Diane, I'm gonna have to find a quicker way to do them if I'm going to redo them all. Can you undo the paper and replace the Epiplex? No, Flick, it's past that, because they're already all sewn together. Do you want to see them? Do you want to see? I'll show you. Stevie? Yeah. On the bookshelf in my, for want of a better word, because we're live on Facebook, studio, in my office, on the bookshelf, back left corner, there's one of those gorgeous red tins that comes every year from our fabric agent with biscuits in it. Oh my god, the biscuits this year were amazing. They used to send chocolate-covered biscuits, and I had to point out to them that chocolate-covered biscuits from a European company via California to arrive in the peak of summer here, not a good idea. We'd get...
Right.
Yeah, we'd get biscuit chocolate mushed stacks, not individual. Un momento. Hi, Jane. Joyce had a sneak. Say, look, I've already put in the tin. BFU Flex ones, they're already in here. So, these were the paper ones. There's nothing wrong with them. Ta-da. If I don't use them, I'll make them a prize and I'll give them away to someone. So, actually, it looks quite black, doesn't it? This is all, yeah, no, I don't like them. They're going. Nope. They're going. There's hundreds of them, but they need to go because the new girl's going onto a cream. She's going onto North Kachima Cream Brulee. If you have cream brulee, or you might be using it for your applique sampler, that is what we're planning on using. So this is on my paper. They're tacked on, and they're in there. Don't like it. Changing it. I might use some of them, but it's, I don't know, I love my, oh heavens, I had lots of paper ones. I had lots of paper ones made. I like my applique. So I think that's quite funny. I've obviously made a conscious decision. And there's, these are the ones that we sell now. They're equilateral octagons. These, I wonder where I put those in. They're the elongated ones. Oh. I must have, I'll rethink that. Anyway, I digress. Okay, so, good morning, Judith. Joy, you're supposed to be going to the bank. All right, now with the method for, so you've got paper piecing in there. You know, if you wanted to do your own thing in the corners, you could. You could do hexagon flowers if you wanted to. I went octagons because to me that was just a little bit more Chinese oriental. And of course it imitates the little shapes inside the wicker on the wicker print. But it's up to you. It's up to you. It really, really is what you want to do in the corners. My applique club girls could do anything now. They've got the skill to do it. They even know how to do the knob on the top without the instructions missing from the pattern I have to fix. Bagging out though, if you haven't... It's not a very nice term, isn't it? So bagging out. Pre-shaping with a stabilizer medium. Let's say it like that. So in the pattern you've got obviously the shape for the lid. Got to go see you on Saturday at Morwell. Okay, Yossa. Oh look, it's like one of those cuckoo clocks. Jeanette's in and Ilse's out. So you're going to be able to cut your pot from here and then that's going to be your lid. And both of these methods use bag out using interfacing that Steve's fixed up the tag for. So that bit that you get in your kit's used for your lid. This bit is used for your pot, so that's all in there and it's going to be quick. It is actually going to be really quick to do that. Now the shape for the pot is in the pattern, but what I'm going to do is show you the same thing, but we're going to pull out a little bit of dragons. And I just happen to have one little bit on my stash bolt that I can chew into. Gee, I wonder if we'll be able to use the boys with the geisha. No, I won't, because these are Chinese. I get a bit funny about that when I put my designer hat on. These are Chinese dragons, and the geisha is Japanese. You wouldn't think I'd get funny like that, would you? But I do. All right. This is one of these great patterns that you can look at, I think, and that's the way it was meant to be. And I've got lots of others out there probably that I didn't do. But this is a good pattern to use to explain to you the bagging out. So when you actually look at these guys, you've got them sideways, sorry. I'll turn for you. You've got a few options for pre-shaping to applique. So you could actually just take out the center circle. You could take out the inner octagon. You could come out to this one here with the little fretwork around it, or go right out to here. Now, I know we've played with this a lot and we've talked about actually cutting out the shape using this seam allowance line here, using the double-sided tape or the hot press rulers, all those things to turn under that seam allowance there, that little quarter inch, and then applique him on. But what I actually want to do this morning is just show you how easy it is to bag something out. When you first look at this though, you'll want to have a look at the back of the pattern. Yvonne, it is, isn't it? It is the best. Pretty much the geisha, this is why I'm saying the outer stuff's what holding me up. The actual geisha is going to happen like that, and I'm probably not like that, but pretty close to that, because we're going to do most of it with bagging out, which will be really, really good. But have a look at the back of patterns first of all. You might not even need to mark anything up or a diagram. So I want that circle, and I can actually see the edge of my circle on the back around the dragon. So just to show you how this works, I'm going to cut a chunk out of this. When it comes to things that you can use for bagging out on the back, if you wanted to, you had a scrap piece of fabric, you could use it. You really could. It's all going to come down to how fine an edge that you want. And if you don't use something that's really, really fine, you might just need to be a little bit more particular about how good your slip stitching is on the edge. Because when you do bag out, you do end up with that seam on the edge that you can just see what you've used to bag out with at the back. So when I slip stitch it on, I have to make sure my needle comes up from underneath and it's coming up into the fold of the right side of the fabric, not into the interfacing underneath, so that you can't see it on the edge. So, planes are coming, Michelle. So when, let me put my glasses on and let's see if I can find a bad bit for you. No. Well, come on, it can't all be good. That's not bad. If I hold, no, you can't see it. Okay, didn't mean to show, but if I hold that up really close and I pull it apart, you can just see the white interfacing underneath. But when I let it go, my slip stitches are actually up in the fold on the right side of the fabric. So when I relax it off, you can't see them. And then I have gone round and quilted just around my ginger jar, just to help it pop up that little bit more. So in this particular, in the pattern, you're not just going to bag out, you're going to pad. So again, to explain what I've done, this is cut down to size. Then I have actually cut out, you would cut out a circle of a lightweight pellon, and Steve's tagged that for me, lightweight pellon, and just, not a seam allowance, just the actual size of the circle, stick that down onto there. To do that, two ways to do it. You can do it really, really carefully by, you know, holding it in place, turning it over and hitting it with the iron. But the other thing you can do is leave it up this way, pop that pellon on, and to get it to adhere, put your applique mat over the top, forming your Teflon applique mat, and then you can hit that with an iron and it will stick. So what we want to do now is grab, I'm going to be naughty and grab one out of a kit and replace it, a piece of non-adhesive, non-woven. Interfacing. It's violin. It's just non-adhesive violin that we used to, or may still put in our cuffs and collars and all those things, and we love to use it for. Adhesive is fantastic, and we do use it a lot, but in this case, I don't want adhesive because I need to be able to turn and press and everything without it sticking. I did entertain the thought of using adhesive, because then when it was all pushed out into shape, you could literally adhere it down onto your background. It's just too messy to do. So these two are going to go together like that, so essentially right sides together, and then move this over a bit. Stephen, can I give you Barb's fabrics? Oh, I'll just sit them here on the stool. It's all right, I'm good. Okay, so now we can. Do you know? I haven't got a foot for the sewing machine. Oh, yes, I do. A foot. So, just to clarify, the octagons that are on the website are equilateral octagons. You will still get a beautiful effect with them, but they're not. The our special ones that we've had made for the cushion and for the geisha, I've just realized we might need to look at making a cushion that does match later on, won't we? Have to make one that matches the geisha. That would be if the actual geisha would go. Fiona has to go, because she'll have to drive home. Can I say? Oh, sleep apnea machine. Yes. Don't have one still, but did have the horrendous surgery instead. What are we on here? Oh, the machine thinks we're still quilting. The machine thinks we're still quilting on the ginger pot, and we are not quilting anymore. There we go. Ah. And he's also telling me, Lisa, if you wish to use your walking foot or anything other than the 1C you've told us that you are using, you need to tell us so that we get the tension right. I did tell you, didn't I, that after all of that stressing over losing my dealership, it's just still there. Nothing happened. It was like, you know, when we were all waiting for the world to end, the cyber world to end in 1999 when we switched over. What? And then nothing happened. Give me a second. I've moved my machine. What's the problem, buddy boo? That all sounds fine. That's all fine. That's all fine. I'm winging it with a walking foot, and I might actually. No, he doesn't like it. Stevie, can you get me my foot case, please? Or it might just be operator error. You know, that happens. Just a tip, girls. We'll have a look. Bit of an on the fly clean and check. Which reminds me, when did you last have your machine serviced? All of that. Ring Tim. Thank you. Check with him. When in doubt, rethread your machine. Please have a nap, make a coffee while you're waiting for me. I actually spoke to him yesterday, and he's coming to. Oh my goodness! I know what it is! Heavens. Heavens, girls, when did that happen? I'm just going to throw this needle in. You can't see my needle. I'm blaming the Bowman for that. She was on this machine last. Steve? Yeah. I need a pack of 19 needles, please. Something has happened. I'm going to show you this. Something has happened. You see that needle? See the bend of it? Something has happened in the transport of my machine from one room to another. Check the bend on that.
Dad.
No. Oh, poor Dad. Poor Dad. I don't know what happened there. When in doubt, you know, I always like to say when in doubt, change a needle. They're not cheap, are they? But they are a necessary. I actually think this machine, I'm going to need them like, oh yeah, that looks a bit better. Our machines get moved around and knocked around a fair bit, I will admit it. Sorry, back to the dealership thing. We are still dealers. It didn't happen. It didn't end at midnight. It did not happen at midnight. So, yeah, if you need anything, we've pretty much removed everything from the website. But if you need, in anticipation, but if you still need anything, please let me know. Lovely. That's a lot better. Poor baby. This was the one, if you saw, I took my spare, it wouldn't work. what did you say, Christine? I took my spare machine to my daughter's. It wouldn't work. Opened it up and oh my goodness, what a mess. Yep. We always like to blame the machine. It's like someone people say, the computer made a mistake. Computers don't make mistakes. Let's try this. There we go. So I am just sewing right round on the edge of this circle to be super particular. Of course I would go around and draw the line in so I could see it better. I would use an open toe foot, all those things. But I just want to show you. So super easy. Actually, I just had a thought. If you, hello. If you were doing more geometric shapes, squares, octagons, hexagons, work into one of the further out shapes on here, or whatever you were doing, on here, and you try a normal violin like this one, and you're not happy that it's sort of stiff enough, please let us know when you order. Put in the comments, I need the stiff one, and we will know what you mean, because what Steve and I were talking about is we've got the one we've got two different ones. We've got the one that he's put up on the website. We've also got this one, which is a non-woven, and it's stiffer. So we'll, you know, I need a really firm one, just to say I need the stiffer one. Please put that in, because we've got two here, so we can do that. I'm just thinking, this one actually feels a lot more like a rice paper, like a paper. So there's two different ones there. We got that one in when the other one wasn't available. It does the job fine, but you've got the option of the two. Okay, so I've been right round. So now I'm going to trim it down, because it is a circle. To get the best result, if you've got a pair of pinking shears, please use them. But I would not recommend in this case, clipping, because your clipping would have to be so fine, so even, and so constant right round, so that you didn't end up with little peaks and valleys in your curve. So for me, I would usually, same as our 3D flowers, pinking shears, or just go a really, really scant quarter inch seam. What a lot of kerfuffle to do, the simplest of things, just to show you. All right, so I'm gonna clip into here, into the violin on the back. You can make that hole as big or as small as you like. If you're going to put a lot of weight on this, don't do what I've just done, which is go with the grain, because it can rip very easily. You would go the other way. If you're doing super small things, you would go that way, and then it doesn't rip as easily. So we'll just turn all that through. Speaking of bagging things out, I'm pretty sure Natasha, if you watch Natasha Makes, I'm pretty sure she's doing the bonsai block from my Oriental Baltimore tonight, and it's got bagged out stuff too. It's got bagged out leaves on it, where we use a good fabric front and back. So it's another finer advancement on this technique as well. So if you do get a chance to watch Natasha, she will be 9 p.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time. So it's a bit later. That will all change with time changes and shifts and stuff. When we go out of daylight saving and they go into summertime, she actually ends up at 7 o'clock. All right. So, but yeah, if you want to see Nat tonight, I'm assuming she'll get to the bagged out leaf, but it is the last of the 9 blocks in her series, and then she'll be doing assembly after that. And then the pressure's on for me to do it. Okay. Applique sampler girls, I gave you a chunk of work in the last one, and next week is applique and Quilter's Life for me. I will come back and do a Facebook show, but I would think it's not going to be until quite late in the week. So late, in fact, I'm probably just going to say right now, 2 p.m. Friday, because we've got the show this weekend, to come back from a show, put everything back in, and I really need to do the next applique mail out, and we're down to the big bit. We're on borders, we're on Banksia block, kangaroo paw block, finishing some others off. So there's a lot of things, and there are, as I've mentioned before, 180 in the club, so the kits, it's a massive job. So I need to do that next week. So I would say we will be Friday afternoon next week, a little bit of a Friday afternoon soiree. We could call it the Chandler's Cottage Long Lunch. All right, so the perfect, pretty much, and that's even with me not really, really being super careful. Perfect circle, done, bagged out and finished. So that could now be easily appliqued onto anything. Stevie, yeah. I love it when he's still there. May I please have a bolt? Just, I think there's still one on the shelf of any Summer Palace border print. Please. Yes. So that is how your pot's going to work, except you're going to draw on an actual shape onto yours. That's so cool. Look, that could go on your cushions to go with your quilt. What do you want?
I think I was going to say that's my favourite.
This one? I've told the girls you've stashed like a whole bolt.
Of the dragon.
That's what happens if you leave him in charge of the warehouse. Yes.
Now.
Oh, what? They're just upside down. However. Yes.
I reckon it's better like that. I'll just stick it there. So then they
let's put it to a break. No, I'm only joking.
It's in front of the machine.
No. So what happened? So we've cut these off. For consistency, we need to...
One's at half inch, one's at 1 inch. I personally prefer the 1 inch, so then you get a better vision of all the fabrics.
Oh, this is what... Okay, can I show the girls? So this is what we do here in our spare time. So I packed this one so the girls can see half an inch, and you packed this one and they can see 1 inch of each fabric.
And then the sticker will go...
Where's the sticker go then? Then the sticker's going to hide two anyway.
Well, not really.
What's the sticker going to do?
Yeah.
Well, are you coming to the show?
Possibly.
You have to tell me when you're coming. You have to come Sunday so you can see Ilsa.
Alright, well, I'm going out Friday night, so I'll...
Sunday.
Yeah, pass me the sticker.
If you come to the show, are you tying back your mullet?
Nope. Full display. Yep.
And there needs to be a mullet warning.
I know how you feel about that.
Yeah.
Okay. So you still see the fabrics.
You want to put it sideways? No?
Ugh. Everyone will be turning their heads. Well, they'll be doing that anyway.
If you're packing them, I'm not arguing with you.
Did you like my joke?
Sorry?
You missed my joke.
What's the joke?
You said put it sideways, and I said everyone will be turning their heads the same way they will be doing when they're looking at the stand.
Oh, you're so funny. Head turner. Head turner? No, it's a small stand, and it's trying to get Lisa Chandler to work in a small space. But then Margaret Upston and Karen Stiles are no different. Right, I just wanted to get this out again. Now that we've all solved the issue with the essential packs.
Wait, what did the ladies think?
Oh, did she join? She did the bonza yesterday morning. Oops. Sorry?
Did we get any viewer input?
No, they're too busy. Flick says she can hear magpies. I don't hear any magpies. Karen, you were so late. We're finished. You'll have to watch it again. All right, so just... I know I've mentioned this one before, but this is a great one as well. This is the Summer Palace that goes with the dragons. We've got it in red and ivory. We have it in a little bit left. Where did this come from?
The shelf.
I sold the last piece yesterday, I thought, to that lady that rang up from Adelaide.
I haven't done those orders yet.
But there's a piece cart sitting near your computer for her. Heavens. That was all gone. We've got this, just this little bit then. I thought I sold the last bit yesterday.
Oh, well, I'd better take that and see how much I've
got. No, there's a piece cut with the order sitting next to the laptop for that lady. We've got it in a couple of colours left. But this one is great. Yeah, on the website. See the little ginger, you've got little ginger jars on there and the houses and vases and things. All of those are big enough for you to bag out because you can do things as little as little leaves like Natasha evidently did yesterday. John's here. that Natasha did yesterday. I missed it. Wow. She means you can watch the bonsai demo now. Yeah, you can go back and watch the bonsai demo now on Natasha Makes. She was cutting that deadline fine because I swear she got that pattern when she got up at 5 a.m., John. I thought she was doing it as block of the month today. Well, there you go. All right. So Natasha Makes for a demo on a teeny weeny one. And that's how you do perfect circle ones, either from a print, or you can just do that with a plate or something. And that is our new little kit. That is up that I will put back. You see, I did the red pot to match. Actually, you need to see this. Do you remember before Christmas, and then we've got work to do. I'm sure you've all got things you need to do. John, you need to go to sleep. do you remember before Christmas? No. During the exhibition online in September, we talked about Felicity's fabric mulch, and she sent us mulch, and we mulched our plant. This is the same mulch, and it has stood this little gorgeous little plant in happiness and moisture for months and months. Look, So Felicity sent me just over. I mean, it's a little bit discolored and stuff now, but it's been fantastic. So that's just another thing you can do with all your little strippy bits when you trim up your fabric before you cut your strips and everything. It is fabric mulch for yours. Oh, you did mulch for Christmas, Barb. Excellent. John wants the last bit of the border stripe. Hasn't Nat got any? She might have some. So I don't have to send it all the way. We'll see. All right, everyone, I'm going to love and leave you because we literally have to go and madly keep packing kits and everything to take to the show. We're also going to pack up our camera gear that you are on here, 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 not there, and a ring light, and take them with us to the show with the switcher and everything in the hope that we can do a live stream from there. It will depend on the reception, and we've learnt this now. There's no point in doing one for you that's going to drive you nuts. So, because you've got really bad reception, it's all blurry. So we'll see how we go. You know when you go somewhere and your phone reception's just a little bit wonky? When you live stream through good camera gear, you need it to be kind of 100 times better than what you have to make a phone call. So we'll get there and see how we go. If not, I'm going to record a few things and then we can pop them up for you. Ivano, we'll see you on Saturday. That is lovely, Barb. What a great idea. Good night, Jonathan. Mwah, big hugs to you. And Flick, I'll catch you next week. Got your email, all of that. So you take care of yourselves. We'll try and get some little sneak peeks for you to the show on the weekend. And have a fabulous day, all right? And we'll see you very soon. And Friday afternoon next week, all right? Bye.